Jain friends, welcome to Royal's Education. WHO has declared COVID-19 a pandemic. It means a disease which has spread globally. After its deadly attack in China, it has poured heavily in Italy and across Europe. It has also spread in the United States. The epicenter of the COVID-19 has shifted from China to Europe. But what is its effect in South Asia, where India lies? In Maharashtra, Delhi, Uttar Pradesh, and almost all over India, the schools, colleges, shopping malls, cinemas, even the temples, churches, and gurdwaras have been shut to contain this deadly virus. The idea of shutting down these places to contain a deadly virus, as coronavirus is called, social distancing, and this is really being effective in COVID-19, means coronavirus disease 19. At the other hand, there are few religious places like masjids where thousands of people are gathering together. They are praying and they are putting their namaz. And there are places for specially made for CA protesting in Shaheen Bagh, in Chennai, in Patna, in Muzaffarpur. And at so many places, people are still joining hands and continue to assemble. They are actually jeopardizing the country's health. Now the question arises, is there any law in our country which can sternly stop this misadventure of these fanatics to play with the country's health? Of course, there is a law and it is called the Epidemic Diseases Act 1897. The central government has taken decision the states and union territories should invoke provisions of section 2 of the act, which will make the health ministry advisory enforceable. That means it can be enforced by the police. So why the state and the union territory should do, why the central government is not invoking this? Because the health is a subject of state list. As we know, in India there are three lists. First is union list, over which the union government makes its laws. Second is state list, over which the state governments makes its laws. And the third one is concurrent list, over which union and state both can make laws, but the union laws will always prevail. Now, this video is created by Megha Singh Rathod and it has got everything about this Epidemic Disease Act 1897, when it was created and what is its efficacy till now. So let's start. Epidemic Diseases Act 1897, there are a total of 151 confirmed cases of COVID-19 in India and there are a total of 3 fatalities, and that too of the older people. States are in battle mode to contain the spread of COVID-19. School, colleges, movies, theaters, temples, and almost all the places of public gathering closed, and most of the exams postponed to contain the spread of COVID-19 across the country. As you know, the IPL has also been postponed. All state and union territories have been directed by the central government to invoke provisions of section 2 of the Epidemic Diseases Act 1897 so that health ministry advisories are enforceable and we will be better equipped with fighting with this Epidemic Diseases Act 1897, if not equipped, at least safe. So the Epidemic Diseases Act 1897 law is meant for containment of epidemics by providing special powers that are required for the implementation of measures to control the spread of the disease. It was first enacted to tackle bubonic plague in Bombay state in former British India. When it was enacted, 1897, and where? In Bombay by Britishers in our country. So it has a total of 4 sections and it aims to provide for better prevention of the spread of dangerous epidemic disease, and it is routinely enforced across the country for dealing with the outbreak of disease. It has already been enforced in our country for 3 times. First, it was forced in 2009 in Pune in Maharashtra to contain the swine flu. Secondly, it was enforced in 2015 in Chandigarh to contain the spread of dengue and maleria. And lastly, last time it was enforced in Vadodara in Gujarat in 2018 to contain the spread of cholera. So let us see that what are the provisions, because the government has asked the states and UT to invoke the section 2 of this act. So section 2 of the act empowers state government UTs to take special measures and formulate regulation to contain any outbreak. So this section 2 says, when at any time the state government is confirmed that the state or any part of the state has an outbreak of any epidemic disease if it thinks that the ordinary provision of the law for the time being in force are insufficient, or you may say not sufficient, for the purpose of containing that deadly disease. So it may appoint or give some powers to its official, and the official or the state may take some measures and by public notice prescribe such temporary regulation to be absorbed by the public to prevent the outbreak of such disease. The state government may take measures and prescribe regulation for the inspection of persons travelling by railway or otherwise, and the segregation in hospital, temporary accommodation or otherwise, if the person who is appointed to do so, if he feels that the certain person is infected. So he can be regulated, inspected in trains, or if you are on the airport, you can be taken by the people from the government offices, and thereafter you can be checked, you can be segregated, you can be put in the hospital, you can put into the temporary accommodation, which will be work as quarantine for you, and it is all for your safety and the safety of your family members. And at the wider perspective, it is helping the country's health. And what is the section 3 of this act? Section 3 is on penalty. Any person, if he is disobeying any regulation or order made under this act, shall be deemed to have committed an offence punishable under section 188 of the Indian Penal Code, 45 of 1860. Section 4 is on protection to persons acting under act. It means that section 4 saves the person who has been authorized to take down this infected person, to regulate them, to search them. So the person who is actually infected, he doesn't go in court and thereafter put some allegation that this man has done, this official has done something wrong to me. So no suit or other legal proceedings shall lie against any person for anything done in good faith intention to be done under this act. Legal protection to implement the act. So there have been so much of criticism of this act, because this was actually brought by the Britishers in 1897 to contain the bubonic plague in Bombay. Bombay is now Mumbai. So historians have criticized the act for its potential for abuse. This act is using powers conferred by the act. Colonies authorities would search suspected plague cases in homes and among passengers, with forcible segregation, evacuation and demolition of infected persons. Means at that time, when the British felt under this act and they had the power, that if they suspected any of the plague cases in any home, they used to forcibly segregate the people, to search them and to evacuate the places, whether it is your personal place or public place, and thereafter demolishing that place, even setting the fire over that place. So in 1897, the year the law was enforced, freedom fighter Bal Gangadhar Tilak was punished with 18 months rigorous imprisonment after his newspaper Kesari and Maharat admonished imperial authorities for their handling of the plague epidemic. And there have been so many narratives in supports also. If you ask my narrative, so I will say that where the whole country is shutting down, schools have been searched, temples have been searched, and the public places have been searched, cinemas, most of the places have been searched. So why a handful of people, why they are protesting? I know that protesting is your fundamental right, you can sit anywhere, but since the country is fighting and every chain, every person counts, then he should not be left, means checked, and he must stay at home. So there are a few protesters standing in Shaheen Bagh, there are people in Chennai, there are people in other places, there are people in Patna, there are people in Muzaffarpur who are protesting against this Citizenship Amendment Act at this time of when the coronavirus has even gobbling, you can say, the whole globe. So that time these people are standing there, sitting there, joining hands. That means they are actually being putting the food to this outbreak. So if required, this act must be in action, and that too by the central government. So constitution experts say if the government believes a colonial era law helps in containing the outbreak, then nothing is wrong in such a decision. The Epidemic Diseases Act 1897, which continues to find relevance in the outbreak of modern day disease in the country, is routinely enforced to restrain the outbreaks of disease such as swine flu, dengue and cholera. I have already told you this has been invoked three times, in 2009, in 2015 and in 2018. So many constitution experts, including two former secretary generals of the Lok Sabha, PDD Acharya and Subhas Kashyap, said if the government thinks a few pre-independence era laws are good enough to fit in the existing circumstances in this time, then there is nothing wrong to keep it to contain the spread of dangerous epidemic disease, because it is for the wider good, it is for the country's health. The law commission usually advises the government on amendment to a law and its modern day relevance. The current government has already repealed many law but has also retained some colonial era law, because the government find that those law are still effective and are doing well in containment of this outbreak of these type of diseases. So the example of implementation I have already given you, but let's see in detail. In 2018, the district collector of Gujarat's Vadodara issued a notification under the act declaring the Khed Karmashia village in Vagodia Taluk as cholera affected after 31 persons complained of symptoms of disease. Then again in 2015, to deal with malaria and dengue in Chandigarh, the act was implemented and controlling officers were instructed to ensure the issuance of notices and challans of rupees 500 to offenders. I am speaking about the section 3 of this Epidemic Disease Act. In 2009, to tackle the swine flu outbreak in Pune, I have already told you section 2 powers were used to open screening centers in civic hospitals across the city, and swine flu was declared a notifiable disease. Here I have completed this Epidemic Disease Act. I think that I have cleared everything in this regard, even the criticism, even the narratives in support, when it was enacted, and what is its relevance and efficacy as of now. Please like it and please share it. Do subscribe to the Royals Education. Thanks. Have a nice day.